Good morning, Titans. Today is Friday, March 10th. I'm Kale Staffamil.
And I'm Vincent Parker. We have an exciting show for you guys today. We will look into the Fire Science Program.
And we'll tell you what NHS is up to.
Sounds good. Let's get to the news. Applications for CTE Works are due May 31st if you're interested in being a firefighter. Reporters Haley Ellis and Andrew Deodorf caught up with college and career advisor Miss Megan Gowdy.
Fire Science is a great program that is run through CTE Works, which used to be called ROP, and it's offered to the students in our district. And it is a fabulous program that is run by a fabulous instructor. His name is Mike Papera, and he has a lot of experience in the fire industry. So he runs this program, and you learn basic medical training, such as CPR, basic first aid, and a number of other things, in addition to, of course, the basic fire training. And so the site that you're training at is actually an old fire station, and so you get to see what it's like to be there and learn about all the engines and the different trainings that they go through. So it's a really cool site. And then after you go through your training, you actually get placed with a fire station or with Cal Fire. And so you get on the job training. You're actually with the guys staying there sometimes and actually get to go out on calls and everything. So it's an awesome program. Like I said, the instructor's name is Mike Papera, and he actually comes out and does interviews for anybody who is interested in joining the program. So because of that, we do have to get registrations for that as soon as possible so that he can schedule those interviews. So if you're interested in that program, you definitely want to register ASAP.
The National Honor Society is holding a tampon drive. Reporters Matthew Milhone and Chase Allen found out why.
NHS is opening a donation drive for homeless shelters with one goal in mind, providing shelters with what they need most, women's sanitary products.
Starting March 10th to April 7th, NHS is going to be hosting a tampon drive. We're hosting this drive because whenever we call in to homeless shelters and women's shelters, we'll always ask, oh, what's like your most needed donated item? And they'll usually say sanitary products because they're just generally pretty expensive to buy, and also a lot of people don't really think to donate them. We also believe that women have the right to basic hygiene and that there's a huge stigma associated with menstruation that shouldn't be the case. So we're collecting tampons and sanitary napkins. We're going to be placing boxes in the office, Mr. Traver's room and Ms. Williams' room, and possibly the dance studio. We're going to be collecting them after school April 7th, and we're going to be donating them probably the weekend after. If you wanted to donate money instead, you would contact the teachers who are participating in the drive.
Chase Allen, Titan TV News.
Senior Robert Anderson is making music. Reporters Chase Allen and Matthew Milhone went to see how he does it.
Music producers are the foundation for today's major artists and spend countless hours mixing and creating soundtracks that would appeal to a large audience. Senior Robert Anderson has been producing music all the way from his first band, The Gray Area, to independent production. With music always on his mind, Anderson hopes to eventually produce tracks for famous artists and become an icon himself.
So it started with Stairway to Stardom for me, musically. I did my first show for that program in 2012, I think. And after I performed for the first time, I kind of just knew that's what I wanted to do for the rest of my life, pursue music. I think it's really rare for kids at that age to know exactly what they want to do for the rest of their lives, but I kind of felt that, and it hasn't really gone away since then. So since then I've been performing at different places, doing different shows, making my own music, putting on shows. But it just hasn't really stopped because it's kind of just a love for the art, and a love for art in general.
Throughout his musical career, Robert has had many colleagues who appreciate his abilities as a musician. However, Robert's parents have been his biggest supporters from day one.
I've been Robert's supporter since he was, I think I noticed that he had musical gift probably when he was 8 or 9. And he learned how to play the piano, a song completely on his own by ear at a fourth grade talent show. And I knew then that he had a musical gift. And since then, it's just been kind of pushing him to do his best as far as being in bands and knowing that he's going to go far, and then watching him evolve as a musician from playing electric guitar and liking alternative music to now being more into R&B and also now mixing his own music. I know it's in him, and I know that he's going to go far with it.
Robert has expanded his gallery of original music to social media and his fan base along with it. Here, he keeps his followers updated with his latest creations to enjoy. Chase Allen, Titan TV News.
Freshman Henrik Movsisian has been practicing judo for almost as long as he can remember. Reporters Austin Nelly and Alex Ross have the story.
Henrik Movsisian is a 14-year-old wrestling and judo prodigy, but some may wonder how one sport would change his life.
Judo didn't really affect my wrestling. The only way it really affected my wrestling is taking down people, and that's it. I got into judo because my dad was a coach in Russia, and then he always wanted his son to do judo and have a future in it, so that's how I got attached to it. I started judo when I was 4 years old. I attended at Sacramento Judo Club, and then about 6 years later, I went to Team Sacramento. I've been doing judo for 11 years now. Hopefully I can make it to Worlds and Olympics. If I make it there, I'm good.
Austin Nelly, Titan TV News.
If you are interested in joining the military, be sure to sign up for the ASVAB test on March 24th.
Winter Guard and Percussion have their second competition on Saturday in the Wood Creek Gymnasium. Percussion plays at 4:40 p.m. and the Guard performs at 11:40 a.m. Tickets are $10 for adults, $5 for students and seniors.
Engineering instructor Mr. Chris Stinson's teaching style is sending students on a path to success.
Engineering teacher Mr. Chris Stinson has a very different way of teaching his classes. He uses a type of teaching called project-based learning to help encourage the students to use their resources and classmates to solve a problem.
In Project Lead the Way, and in the past, before I even taught Project Lead the Way, I've always used applied, problem, project-based learning. So I pretty much do front loading or set them up with the problem or the project, and then I kind of leave them alone. It's more like a coach or a facilitator rather than like a teacher talking the whole period.
Students taking the course find this style of learning challenging, but students soon find it beneficial and interesting.
For like a day, he usually gives like full directions, and after that you're pretty much on your own because you're expected to know what to do. He usually makes us take notes on stuff too to help out. I like working by myself, and when I'm taught something once, I pretty much already know it. So
I think it's very effective because kids learn by doing. And when you give them some space and you give them the opportunity to collaborate with other kids in the class. So a lot of our work in here is partner based or small group based, cooperative groups. So it's nice to see them collaborate. The challenge for a teacher, I think, is to not step in. You know, right? You want to help, you know that they're struggling, but the challenge is to step back and make sure they do their work on their own, even if it's a struggle.
David Katerchuk and Kale Staffenbill, Titan TV News.
Reporter Brian Robinson shoots for the stars in this week's Man on the Street.
Welcome back. We have another Man on the Street this week about space. Today, we found the rings of Uranus, and we also launched a new satellite to Mars. Let's go! All right, Ethan. What is the name of Earth's moon?
Moon.
Mayonnaise.
Great, great answer. Can either of you name the name of Earth's moon?
Moon.
M-O-O-N.
Beautiful, beautiful. You both have it correct. Thank you. Bye. How many planets are there?
I don't know.
How many?
10.
Great answer. Perfect. You got it right.
Do you know the planets that have rings?
Saturn.
And?
No.
And? And? Great job. All right, my lanky young friend. Can you name all the planets?
Absolutely not.
Good answer. Can you name Mars's latest rover?
Apollo 13.
You got me. I'm not going to lie. Correct answer. Thank you.
Well, that's all for this week.
I can't believe next week is midterms.
Guess we better start studying.
I guess. Have a great Friday, Titans, and an even better weekend.